All right, it's Oscar night. We're off to the Academy Awards to tear up the red carpet with Chris Rock, Jennifer Lawrence, and... Okay, so we're obviously not going to the Oscars, but we've got the next best thing. Sky is changing its Sky Movies Greats channel to Sky Movies Oscars in honor of the 88th Academy Awards. As well as broadcasting the ceremony live from the Dolby Theatre on the 28th of February, Sky is serving up a roll call of winners from previous years. Over 140 Oscar-winning movies will be available to watch on the Sky Movies Oscars, with another 50 movies available to watch on demand. We've not got enough time in the day to list them all, so here's some of our favourites. Birdman. The irreverent Birdman scooped 4 Oscars at last year's awards, including Best Motion Picture and Best Director. Alejandro Iñárritu's surreal and satirical comedy stars Michael Keaton as a washed-up Hollywood actor who, desperate for critical recognition and respect, stages a self-aggrandizing Broadway adaptation of a celebrated short story. All the while, he's tormented by hallucinogenic visions of his alter ego, Birdman, his inner demons personified in the form of his younger self who shot to fame in the late 80s when he was starring in trashy superhero movies. Backed by an incredible supporting cast including Ed Norton, Emma Stone and Zach Galifianakis, Birdman is a risky and ludicrous movie that threatens to fall apart any second, but is held together by incredible performances, direction and cinematography. Batman. Speaking of Michael Keaton, it would be wrong of us not to point out that the 1989 Batman film is also coming to Sky Movies Oscars. While this Bat movie is notable for Jack Nicholson's iconic turn as the Joker and Danny Elfman's timeless score, it actually won an Oscar for Best Art Direction, which is perhaps not that surprising. The gothic Art Deco stylings of Batman continue to quite literally cast a shadow over the brooding superhero genre, even today. This year we're seeing another Batman movie hitting the big screen which looks set to mine that same gloomy seam stuck by Tim Burton and the gang over 25 years ago. Silence of the Lambs. Speaking of 25 years, it's been that long since Silence of the Lambs nabbed 5 Oscars at the 1992 Awards. Sky Movies Oscars has bagged this taut psychological thriller as part of its lineup, and it invites you to help track down notorious serial killer Buffalo Bill, along with FBI Special Agent Clarice Starling. Clarice is aided in her quest by one Dr. Hannibal Lecter, who, it turns out, is also a violent serial killer, albeit a highly intelligent and charismatic one. Jodie Foster and Anthony Hopkins both won awards for their performances as Starling and Lecter, and Jonathan Demme bagged an Oscar for Best Director. Not only is Silence of the Lambs currently the only horror movie to win an Oscar for Best Picture, it's also the only Oscar winner to feature The Fall on its soundtrack. Little Miss Sunshine. It seems hard to believe that Little Miss Sunshine is 10 years old, but there you go. This deceptively dark comedy starts life as something of a family road movie, but it soon turns into something entirely different. Little Miss Sunshine comes off as an indie movie that somehow managed to assemble a big name cast. The directorial debut of Jonathan Dayton and Valerie Faris stars Greg Kinnear, Steve Carell, Toni Collette and Alan Arkin, plus 2 then relatively unknowns Abigail Breslin and Paul Dano. First-time scriptwriter Michael Arndt won an award for Best Original Screenplay, while Arkin scooped an award for his turn as foul-mouthed grandfather Edwin. Given Little Miss Sunshine's implied criticism of success and the notion of winning, it's perhaps an odd stablemate for other Hollywood giants, but wouldn't it be boring if all Academy Award winners were the same? And finally, we've got Titanic, or have we got Return of the King? We're really torn between these two for the top spot, to be honest. Both movies have won 11 Oscars each, which means they're tied for the top spot of most Oscars won by any movie ever, so we feel like they both deserve a mention. But to be frank, I'm not really a fan of either movie. I appreciate that some of you might not agree with my opinions about either film, so I'm giving you the chance to tell me how wrong I am in the comments. In the description, you'll find a link to a list of all of the movies that Sky Movies Oscars will be showing over the coming weeks, meaning you're free to go and compile your own top 5, then come back here and tell me how stupid I am in the comments. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've just got to take this call from Peter Jackson. Hi Pete, how's it going? Yeah, I know Summer Ends in the extended edition. I've seen it like 100 times. No, I do like it. I just don't like it as much as The Two Towers. Is that okay? Pete? You still there?